All right, to introduce you to temporal difference learning, it helps to have a little bit of context about reinforcement learning in a more general way so we can see how the different methods for doing reinforcement learning fit together.
Okay.
So I'm going to think about reinforcement learning this way. Remember we talked about SARSes, right? The state, action, reward sequence. So I'm in a state, I take an action, I get a reward back, I end up in a new state, I take a new action, I get a new reward, and this just continues. So I put a little cleany star after it to indicate that this is some sequence of state action rewards. That's what comes as input to a reinforcement learning algorithm. And what the reinforcement learning algorithm produces as output is a policy.
Sure, that makes sense. Hey, I got a quick notational question for you, though.
Sure.
Should that really be a cleany star, or should it be a plus?
Well, I'm being a little bit lax with notation here, but I'm imagining that even if you give a reinforcement learning algorithm no history at all, it could still come out with an initial policy.
Sure, that makes sense. In fact, I guess that's true for every algorithm we've ever talked about.
I think so. I mean, it could just be a default policy, like in all states, take whatever the first action is. But the fact of the matter is, over time, I mean, the interesting case is when we've had some amount of history and we're trying to map that to some behavior.
Okay, I'm on the same page.